Hey, Denton, I am so excited to share my conversation with Ryan Beatty of Notable Inspections. He's a home inspector who is very methodical, very detail-oriented, but at the same time, he has a knack for being able to translate his findings from the home inspection to everyday people who aren't immersed in that field every single day like he is. If you are a first-time home buyer, definitely check out what he has to say. There can be a lot of fear and emotions that go into the home inspection part of the process, so I think his insights will really help remove some of that fear. And also, if you're thinking about selling your home, he's got some great tidbits for you as well. Let me know what you guys think. Enjoy.
Well, thank you so much, Ryan, for joining us. I am going to ask you to go ahead and introduce yourself, but let's go ahead and get your last name out of the way.
My name is Ryan Beatty. I'm originally from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. In Canada, we say Beatty. Most people in Texas say Beatty, so I don't really get offended either way that you say my name.
I'd love to know a little bit about how you got into the home inspection field. What kind of drew you to the industry?
Well, I was a software engineer for 15 years. My mom was a realtor. I'm married to a realtor, so I've been around it for a long time. I loved what I was doing as a software engineer, driving from Denton to downtown Dallas every day, got a little old, and just the corporate red tape. And I was at a point in my life where I just wanted to make a change. And so I did it. And I love it. I always wanted to do this. And I think it's an advantage have being married to a realtor and having a mother who is a realtor. She was also an appraiser. I think that helps me speak to the clients and the home buyers and doesn't scare them away because I've been around it for so long.
I love that. And I think that's so great that you have perspective from a lot of different angles on the different sides of the transaction. And one thing you said while we were chatting on Instagram before that I really liked and I wanted to share with any viewers here is that your goal is to educate, not intimidate. And exactly. I know from experience as an investor myself, as a realtor that helps first-time home buyers that are new to the inspection process, it can be a really, really scary part of the process. So can you just elaborate on what exactly a home inspection is and why it's important?
Right. And that's why the walkthroughs are very, very, very important at the end of the inspection. So typically a home inspection takes me about 3 to 4 hours to complete prior to you coming with your clients at the end. Now I am offering, because it's COVID times, I offer Zoom, Skype. I've done Facebook and some other platforms of at least video walkthroughs because they are very important. Not every state has a governing body over inspectors like Texas does. Like you and I report to the same governing body, that's TREC. So that it is very regulated, it can be very intimidating because there are so many things that we have to write up and some of them aren't a big deal. But the way that the report is laid out, it can seem kind of scary because if the house is not 100% perfect, I'm going to have to write it up and I'm going to have to write that category is deficient. And if I were to just email the report, that could make someone like very intimidated the way that the state has laid out the report that I have to use. I am regulated to use that report. I can't change it. I can add as much to it as I want, but I think that it's already kind of complicated. So I try to just keep it simple. But yes, doing the walkthrough at the very end makes a world of difference because I'll do what I call my track talk. I talk for about 10 minutes before I even get into the walkthrough about why I have to write up certain things that I do. And it just makes so much more sense.
That's great. And that is good to know that you have alternative methods to kind of do that summary at the end for whoever has hired you for that home inspection. Because I know it's just a little complicated right now. Not everybody's comfortable with every scenario. So I think that's really awesome.
Yes. And that's important what you talked about too, is I do include a summary at the end because things get lost in the report just because it is, you know, it's long.
Yeah. And I'm sure you can back this up. There's no such thing as a perfect house, right?
Nope. Even in new construction, and people ask me, it's new construction. I don't need to get it inspected. Yes, you do. Because now, you know, we're not allowed to pick on builders, so I'm not going to use any other names. But some of them actually go out of their way, and they actually hire an inspection firm that inspects the home during construction. There are a couple builders that do that. There are a couple builders that try to deter you deter you, the buyer, from getting an inspection. They've put a bunch of regulations on us. Unfortunately, they're not regulated by Trek, so they get to kind of do their own thing. So I always say to the agents, make sure that you get in, like when you're signing the paperwork, when you're getting that before the foundation's ever been poured, that you make sure that you are allowed to get a home inspection.
Awesome.
Process, because I always find things, it's not the builder's fault necessarily, you know, you've got mm-hmm. one builder that might be building 20 houses at the same time, and he's got all these contractors in there, he can't go around make sure everything's right. But you might have a really great framing company out there that's done an excellent job on the framing, there's nothing wrong with the framing, and then the mechanical people have come in putting in the HVAC or the you know, the electrical and the plumbing, and they may have notched or bored the holes in the framing incorrectly, which could compromise the integrity of the framing. So I offer what I call phased inspections. So when it comes to new construction, so I'll come out before the slab is poured to make sure all the plumbing and everything in the foundation is right before you put concrete on it, because you can't fix it after, or it's very hard to fix. I do what I call the pre-drywall or pre-sheetrock inspection. So I'll come before they put the insulation in, just to make sure that everything in the walls is good. And then the final inspection, which is pretty much same as a pre-existing home inspection prior to close.
That's so great. And I couldn't agree more with that statement. Just because it's a new construction building or on the newer side doesn't mean there aren't things that could potentially determine, you know, what you want to do with that property. So on that note, are there any common deal breakers that you would say you see that maybe sellers could try and mitigate a little bit more before they list their home?
Your home is your biggest investment. My biggest tip to sellers is, I mean, it is one of your biggest investment, is take care of it. There's annual maintenance you need to do. And average, ballpark average HVAC system is about, only because I know I had to replace it on my last house in Denton, was about $7,000. So spend the $150 a year to have it serviced. Things like that. Just take care of your biggest investment, and then you won't have as many issues down the line. I haven't really seen any what I would call deal breakers, because anything can be fixed. Even a foundation can be fixed. Don't let it intimidate you. Unfortunately, that's when I hand it back to you, the agent, and you get to do the negotiations, figuring out if it's something that should be fixed or you should get money back in some way, shape, or form.
I'm totally with you on there's, you know, things can be repaired. So it's just a matter if it makes sense for where you're at in your budget and the work that you're willing to take on as well. And also there's it's a good tool to, you know, finalize negotiations as well, because sometimes the sellers really don't know that they have a big issue that could really mm-hmm. potentially affect the price of their home. So it is good to bring this up to the sellers when you're in that option period. So you guys can hopefully come to a win-win solution. And it's not going to necessarily work out every time, but that's what that option period's for. And that's what's really important, to get the inspection no matter what.
Yep. Try to get the inspection as close to the beginning as possible so you can figure out all those things along the way. I do research my houses the night before. These are all things I make note of. Oh, this house was built in 2002. I need to check for this, this, and this. So things like that.
Yeah, that's a great point. The age of the home is going to potentially present different types of problems. So an experienced inspector is going to be really important and a great advocate for any home buyer or investor. You mentioned you're from Canada.
Yes.
What is your favorite part about Denton?
I think I mentioned this to you before. Just keep Denton weird. It's quirky. I love it.
Absolutely.
I love that aspect about it. It's like a mini Austin without it being Austin. So.
Exactly. No, yeah. I'm totally with you there. Well, thank you so much. If people want to ask you more questions about the home inspection process or even see if you're available to do one for them, where can they find out more about you?
Easiest place is notableinspections.com. You can chat with me right on my website. You can make a booking on my website. You can pay on my website. You can do everything from there. You can call from there. So,
awesome. Thank you so much, Ryan. Hey, appreciate your time.
You bet.